Sorry about that. I completely forgot that there was a cutscene right there. Alright. So we're in the first area of the first world. To do a couple of things before we head into the actual world itself. Oh, what do you know? We have enough puzzle pieces. Jiggies, alright. Of course we're worthy. We're the heroes! Unlocking the world is a little bit different from the first game. It's in the form of a mini game. Not like the first game where you just put the puzzle pieces in. I hate this mini game because it's timed. First one's easy. It's the ones later in the game, but it's a pain. Yep. This one. Oh, wrong one. Yahoo! Oh, this is a cool cutscene right here. Thank you. course I don't. Need four. Anyways, that cutscene was awesome, but it made no sense. Beam was shooting up, but it came sideways. Whatever. But, remember when I played this game... How long has it been? Almost 15 years? I remember seeing that cutscene, I was like, oh man, it's an awesome cutscene. Anyways, let me not explore. Oh! I was pressing the wrong button. Yeah, I'll explore that later. Let's go ahead and start the first world. An Aztec themed world. It's pretty good. Mayhem Temple. I wish the first game had this, the warpad. But no, quite useful. Especially in places like Planker's Cave or in the first one. But I'm glad this game has it. The worlds in this game are huge. Oh, hate those things. No! I already have 100 of those. Maximum of those, too. Alright, let's see. What do we do? I like how all the items are now in the forms of nests. Now, if I remember right, the first game, there's 100 notes in each world. I think in this game, some worlds have more than 100 notes, if I remember right. Oh, what do you know? Jinjo up there. Oh yeah, Mumbo Magic. Oh man. Oh, I remember that. Hate playing as Mumbo. Very limited moveset and all. Especially in the later part of the game where it's really hard. Oh! Oh! The first new move! Alright, let's see what move we're gonna learn. This is an awesome first move. You can turn the game first person shooter style. But yeah, unlike Bottles where you just learn the skill just by talking to Bottles, you have to actually pay him notes, which is why collecting notes is much more important in this game than the first game. Well, I guess it was important, as important in the first game, since you need notes to unlock the doors. Alright, let's see. Oops. Oh no. Reset. What was the button? C button. Oh. This is what he meant. So yeah, we can actually shoot eggs now. First person view. Rather than shooting blindly. Oh, another Jinjo. Jinjo, get you later. Ah, yes. I shouldn't have wasted those eggs. Oh well. I think they respawn, but anyways. Oops. Oh, what the? That was a lucky shot. Okay. Pressing the wrong button. I am pressing. How do I shoot? Hate how. Oh, okay. Now I know how to shoot, but my aiming controls are inverted. Ugh, I hate that. There we go. I remember when I first played this level, I could never figure this out. I think I got the puzzle piece in this place, in this area, later in the game, on my first playthrough. Okay. Wait, are there any eggs here? Oh, nope. It's a honeycomb item place thingy. Forgot the name. Alright. Treasure chamber. Oh. So in that mini game that we played earlier, it was showing this guy, but let's see. Oh, what do you know? One step closer to increasing our health. Oh. Doesn't seem like there's much we can do in here yet. To find a flying pad so we can go flying up this tower.